relationship question of the day here.
Question of the day.
We're all about the questions, of course. And this one says, have you ever been in a relationship where initially you enjoyed the confidence of your partner seeming to have all the answers?
All right.
Only to find out that they come off as more of a know-it-all in the end. Well, that is where we're going with today's Building Healthy Relationships session on Franky and Ro Q&A.
That's right. Hey, thanks for joining us here. Juicy Relationship Q&A, where it's all about mature conversations about relationships. And today's post definitely is an interesting one.
Sounds
like Brother Man don't want to listen. He know it all.
I don't know. Somebody think they know it all. So we about to get to it.
Somebody got all the answers. But yo, if this is your first time checking us out, hey, here we come together each week talking about different posts online for relationships. Our community is really strong here. Take a moment to subscribe and get in on it. Maybe you need help or you can help somebody else. But with that said, go ahead. Take it away, lady, with the post.
Today's post comes from the Facebook group Marriage Unmasked.
Okay.
And the question is, can a marriage survive if your spouse doesn't listen or hear anything that you say? If it's not something he or she agrees with, then it's automatically the wrong thing, nor does he or she accept their own flaws, but yet can always point out yours.
Oh, he got all the answers. That, that reminds me of one of my brothers that, you know, he would always tell me what I needed to do. But when it came to his life was just a hot mess. So I totally understand where she's coming from. But what are your thoughts?
I can relate to this post because there was a point in time. Now, don't get me wrong. My husband is a very educated man, very educated, very smart, knows his stuff.
Here we go.
But Tom.
Here we go.
There was a time in our relationship where I felt like whatever I said was not it at all. Did you hear the tease? Not it at all.
I mean, was it? I mean, you know. Go ahead. Keep going.
So it just felt like whatever I said was wrong. Whatever he said was right. Now, don't get me wrong. You know, I'm a woman who believes that the man, the husband, is the leader of the home. He is the head of the household, the husband. And so, you know, kind of coming up in that old school way of living, or the old school way of being married, of course I listened to him because he was my covering. So I trusted in everything that he said. I believed in everything that he said because I felt it was for the better of our family, which it was. But it felt like every time that I had something to say or an input or an idea or a suggestion, it just wasn't, no, that's not it. And it kind of made me feel like I was not the partner in this, that I was just somebody there who was there to listen to whatever he said, and whatever he said went, it goes, and that's how it is. So once I started to finally communicate these things years and years later, and he actually started to put on his listening cap, like they say in school. Let's put our listening hats on, everybody. So when he finally did that, I guess he kind of seen that, you know what? I was that way. I did do that because I felt that I was the man who beat my chest, you know, that I had to give direction. I had to be leading everybody. I had to be ahead of this thing. And I get that too. However, he finally came around and started to understand that, hey, my wife, you know, this is a really smart, beautiful chick over here. And the things that she is saying, actually, you know, I'll be damned. It makes sense. So, yes, I kind of understand where this post is coming from and where it's going. But it all comes down to actually listening to your partner and what they are saying versus being the know-it-all. Nope, you don't know what you're talking about, because that's going to drive a huge web in your relationship when it comes to communication.
Yeah, I mean, you have to be cautious because, of course, you want your spouse to feel heard. You don't want to drive a wedge in your relationship because of listening. First off, though, I would say, sis, don't fault yourself in this situation. This one goes way deeper than you. The Bible passage, for example, there's a scripture, I think it's John 1:1. Yeah, that's what I want to focus on. It reminds me of this situation. And pulling it up on the screen, it says, in the beginning was the Word. The Word was with God, and the Word was God. It literally goes into like the origin story of the Trinity. Mm-hmm. Digging a little bit deeper, and I'm not trying to get religious at this point. It's almost like Bruce Wayne. When Bruce Wayne was in that alley, his life was changed the moment that robber shot his father and mother, and those pearls were all draped on the street. He went from Bruce Wayne to Batman. Mm. There's other stories like Diana to Wonder Woman. Mm-hmm. Where I'm going with all this origin story to kind of keep things simple is when it comes to these stories, everything had a beginning. And I would encourage you to get to the root of where all this came from, because getting to the root of all that will allow you to understand how to communicate with mm-hmm. this man. What are your thoughts?
That very well is true. I like the points that you made and the examples that you use. And I sometimes feel like with men that they are born with this inner leadership. You know what I mean? They are born with this this thing in them that causes them want to lead their families or lead their wives or be leaders, natural born leaders. They're born with this. So when they take that and it kind of transitions into this know-it-all situation, I don't know, ego, I don't know what you want to call it. But when it transitions into that, it becomes a problem. Now, being a bred-born leader is fine. That's what we want. That's what women want. We want leaders. We want leadership in our life. We want that to come from our husbands. Yes, we do. However, like I said, when it transitions over to I know it all and you don't, or you don't know anything, then it becomes a real life problem. And now we got some other stuff we got to deal with besides everything else we're trying to deal with as a married couple. Now we have this that we need to put in check, because we are putting your lives just to sit silent and not be someone who has wisdom or knowledge. We're not putting your lives for that. We're putting your lives to also be a helpmate, to also give our opinions on things, to also help guide and also be leaders in the home. We lead the children. We lead the home. You know, we're leaders as well. So when we feel like we aren't, we feel belittled. We right. feel like we're not anybody. We feel like whatever we say does not matter. And when that happens to us, we start to become other people.
Right.
We start to become you wanted this wife, you wanted this mother to your children, you wanted this person who's leading your home as well while you're off making the bread. But when we aren't allowed to do this, something happens.
So continue to work with him, get to the root of what's going on, mm-hmm. and just try to make those attempts to build on a relationship.
Right. Totally agree. It's all about the communication. Everything in relationships always leads back to communication. I don't care what it is. Kids, work, finances, faith, sex, whatever it is, it all leads back to communication. So if you feel like you are married to a know-it-all and whatever you say never goes, or your input never goes, your suggestions never go, then this is where we need to sit down and talk and say, hey, we're in this together. We make decisions together. We come up with things that are beneficial to our family and to us together. So please allow me to have some input in everything that we do.
Yeah, I mean, and another thing I would definitely say is be cautious about even calling him a know-it-all. What I mean by that is don't automatically assume that he's wrong in everything, but come to the table with an open mind, because when you already have it in your mind that he's always wrong, he'll never admit that he's wrong, that also jades you in your decision making in the relationship. Facts. Yeah.
You got to learn with this type of person, you got to learn how to flip it on them. You got to learn how you got to learn how to flip it, because if you don't, you're going to be in a world of trouble all the time. You know, I understand what you're saying, baby. That sounds real good. I agree. That's just like saying, you know what? We have a steak, lobster, shrimp, potatoes. We having all this tonight for dinner. I'm going to hook it up. We're going to sit down. We're going to eat. You know, baby, that sounds real good. The steak, the shrimp, the lobster, the potato. That sounds great. But what about if we take the potato off and replace that with a salad? You know, that'll make us feel more healthy. That will make us feel, you know, better about ourselves. Sometimes you just got to learn how to flip it. You feel me? We all know we can't fix everybody. We're not here to fix people. People have to want to be better and people have to want to do better. So if he feels like he's not a know-it-all, he doesn't feel like he doesn't see anything wrong with him being the way he is, it's always going to cause trouble and strife in your relationship because he sees no problem with it, but you do. So you don't want him to turn on you and in this same scenario say, I'm not wrong. You're wrong. You're always treating me as I'm this, that, or the other. Or you're always looking down on me as if I'm this, that, or the other. So what you're seeing may be something totally different than what he thinks that he is. So that little situation right there is dangerous in himself. And if you try to fix him, it's definitely not going to work until he sees what's actually going on with his own eyes.
Right. Kind of wrapping this one up. In the end, focus on ways to minimize conflict. I mean, if you know he's going to create an argument, it's really fruitless for you to sit there and argue with someone over something that's not even real or true. Right. So start to work on avoiding those confrontations and, you know, maybe try to seek outside counseling. But typically a know-it-all won't do that in the end. So just kind of work from there. I mean, those are our best suggestions.
Yeah.